So today you have a demonstration in a pedestrian environment.
This is a public trial, a public demonstration of some of our driverless technology. And the public are touching and interacting and letting their children running around in front of the vehicles. And instead of running on the roads, we're running on shared spaces, on pavements, through subways.
Many people are focusing on sort of on-road driving, which means you're kind of on a motorway and there are lane markings and you basically try to follow the lane, right? It's actually much harder to have something that is in an unstructured environment. By that I mean there are no lanes here. And whether that's a pod or a car or a forklift truck or a mining vehicle really doesn't, or a Mars rover for that matter, really doesn't matter. The point is it moves, it needs to answer those questions. And the technology that we've developed here at Oxford very much aims to be a generalist at that.
Driverless cars in itself would be enough, but then when you think about, well, how does that map to warehousing? How does that map to manipulation? All the other things that we can't do in robotics, we've got great ambition and we're just getting started really.
I have like millions of projects now in mind. And yeah, our backgrounds are computer science, they're electrical engineering, mechanical engineering, physics. I mean, this whole combination of skills makes it quite incredible.
And having pulled off something like this as an educational institution is something truly extraordinary. So, you know, I feel a lot of pride. I feel a lot of pride in what we as an institute and as a university as such, in collaboration with our partners like the Transport Systems Catapult, have achieved.
We're quite a tight group. Yeah, again, I think it's really just the start, so there's lots to do.